Get a banana and a box of toothpicks. Now you're gonna take one of the toothpicks out. You can also do a sewing needle. And the banana should be yellow with a couple brown spots on it for this to work. So you set the banana down on the table, and now you're gonna go down about 1 inch, and you're gonna poke the toothpick into it, and you're gonna tap it gently, and you want it to go all the way to the other side, but not so far that it comes out the other side. So you'll start to feel it poking through, but you don't want it to actually pierce through the other side of the banana. And you're gonna hold it like a pencil, and you're gonna swing it back and forth, and then you bring it along the side of the banana, and see, you can almost see it there. So it goes all the way up, and you pull it out there, and now you're gonna do this in the other direction, where you don't poke it all the way through, but you just sort of run it along the side, and you bring it up there. And when you're done with that, you close that bit of the banana off. If banana juice comes out, that's okay, because that's going to reseal. Now, you go about 2 inches down from there. Again, you push that through. Don't let it come out the other side. You're going to swing it so it comes off this side. As you swing, be careful not to break the toothpick inside the banana. If you break the toothpick inside the banana, you're going to have to do it again. Now, that time I poked through. It's okay because it was a small poke. But if you poke too big, you might have to start over. And again, that hole will start to heal on its own. You can see that first hole is already healing. And now one more. This is about 2 inches down. And swing it one way. Yep. Now I'm going to take another toothpick because I can feel that first one is starting to get a little soft, which means it could break easier. Then I'm going to bring the toothpick back that way. And then there's one last hole that we're going to make. First, we'll seal that hole up. And you can see those holes are sealing nicely. We'll do one last one there. So this one is a little closer to the bottom. And then you need to remember how many slits you've made in the banana. Here, I've made 4. All right. So we've sewn that through, and now we're going to seal up that hole. Now, when the banana is here, it's better to keep it on this side rather than this side. But if you wait even longer, those holes, even though they're going to turn brown, they'll really seal up on their own. And now what I like to do is I get a plate and a knife. I have the banana sitting this way. And then if I'm hanging out with someone, I ask them if they want a banana. And if they do, I say, here, hold on to it for a second. So they hold on to it. And then I say, don't open it yet. Or maybe I'll say, start to open it. Open it like, just crack the top. So they crack the top, but that's it. So they know it's really sealed up. Then what I do is I take a knife. And you can do this too. This is a great trick. You take a knife and I tap 2, 3. 4, because you remember we made 4 cuts in the banana. So you tap 4 times. Then when your friend peels the banana, they're going to get something crazy, which is they're going to get a banana that's already been sliced for them inside of the peel. So if you're a performer, you like to mess with your friends, you can do this. Or if not, you can share this video. Maybe one of your friends would like to see it, and maybe it's something they can do if they're just stuck at home without something cooler to do.